Adrian Brown reporting there from Beijing. Powerful aftershocks are still shaking parts of southern Japan after Saturday's earthquake there on the island of Kyushu. At least 100,000 people are still thought to be living in emergency accommodation. Harry Fawcett reports from Minami-aso in Japan.
In the hills above Minami-aso, the scars show the power of what happened here. Vast swathes of mountainside gave way, leaving a twisted checkerboard of turf and soil, and pulverizing a small group of houses. One body was pulled from the earth here on Tuesday. Five more people remained missing well into the fourth day since Saturday's 7.1 magnitude quake.
Realistically, 72 hours is the limit for survival, but we don't really want to think like that. We'll keep the rescue effort going as long as we can.
A few kilometers away, another team of hundreds was digging through another landslide. A holidaying couple had been staying in a mountain lodge here. On Monday, the man was pulled out, lifeless. On Tuesday, they searched for his wife. The sniffer dogs, who'd spent almost all of Monday at the site, weren't called for. Well, this is still a huge operation, but there is a sense that its intensity is shifting somewhat. There's a feeling of grim, thorough determination about all this, rather than a race against time. Down in the valley, we found some of the 94,000 earthquake evacuees. Criticism about the aid effort, a lack of food and water, seems to be easing as supplies
come in. Up to 300 million people in the world.
To houses without water or power, especially when strong aftershocks continue to strike, as one did during our interview.
There are still so many of these. We can't go home with everything shaking.
In Ishihara, one family has gone home, but only to clear out what remains of it and salvage what they can. It's hard to believe that this used to be the first floor. Harder to believe that seven people, including three grandchildren under five, were asleep on the ground floor when Saturday's quake brought the house down on them, and that all of them crawled out with nothing worse than scratches.
I feel sorry for people who've lost their lives, but I'm so glad that we are all alive. I didn't really think about the house, just about protecting my family.
Other families are still waiting to be reunited with their loved ones, if only so that they can begin properly to grieve. Harry Fawcett, Al Jazeera, Minami-aso, Japan.